There are fears of job losses and rising electricity prices as the country's largest coal-fired power station is shut down early. The decision by energy giant Origin has been blamed on a faster shift to renewables.
The sun shines over the Eraring power station on a dark day for workers.
Let me be clear about the fact that we're exiting coal.
Origin to shut down its site in 2025, 7 years earlier than expected, affecting around 400 staff directly and many more across the town.
It's a bit of a slap in the face for the guys that work there.
And increasing concerns over the ability to keep the nation's lights on.
It's a disappointment to the workers in the Lake Macquarie region, but it's also a disappointment for the electricity grid.
Eraring supplies 20% of New South Wales's power and connects to a grid that feeds electricity to other eastern states and South Australia. It is the largest of 16 coal-fired stations in the country. Seven will shut by 2035. All will be turned off by 2051 as Australia transitions to more renewable energy.
The market is really rapidly changing in energy.
Origin plans to replace the 2,880 megawatt site with a 700 megawatt battery to store energy from wind and solar, the state government pledging a battery of the same size, claiming it will run around the clock, replacing half of the lost power.
There is a lot of new capacity for energy coming into the market.
The challenge for governments and the private sector in managing the transition away from coal to gas and renewables is to ensure the lights stay on and prices stay down.
When Victoria's Hazelwood Power Station closed in 2016, wholesale prices soared 85% in 2 years.
The closure of Eraring could put upward pressure on electricity prices.
I look forward to a future where there's also lower emissions.
But it might not be easy to be green. Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.